on the mat. Alright, so start of the third quarter. And Pines well and truly in control of this game. Can Salford make a comeback? Leave the first couple of goals of you, give them a chance, but as it is, umpire Denley will say, I'll ball it up once again. Just the attacking side of the centre here for Salford. Derek Chakwig has kicked three goals for Salford out of their four, and Aaron Edwards has kicked four for Pines out of their 11. Here's a chance. Herbert, long kick towards full forward. In fact, just goes up a little bit. Actually, tuck in the back pocket there for Pines.
Needed to do more there with that kick. That was the entry they needed early. Needed to do more. Find a target. Got a key goal.
Gudanovic went harder than Smith there. Now a chance for Potts. Luke Potts goes with a kick down towards half forward. And Guy Hendry. Actually, he's been pretty good also.
Absolutely.
Short pass. Mark taken by Strawn. 50 metres out from goal. And a kick around the corner towards Messina, who takes the mark 35 metres or so out from goal. Pretty much directly in front of this should be their 12th goal.
Yeah, just disappointing for Seifer. They got the entry they wanted early. They looked dangerous. It went inside 30. Just a poor kick. Pines, as they've done most of the day, transition really quickly, very clean. Got some big targets up front. And now they're out for a shot at goal. So it continues on, Bossy.
Okay, so Messina it is. Has a solid goal and puts it through for a goal. And he's been on off the ground, but Jamie Messina's put through, I think that's his second goal. It is his second goal, in fact. So Pines with the opening goal of the third quarter. Something which Seaford could all afford to happen. 12-4-76, plays 4-4-28. And that's on the Rye Hotel scoreboard. And the 8 goals, in fact. And poor buddy Glenn, he's copping an absolute flogging. The runner there for... He's copping a flogging for Pines.
Certainly working out, isn't he?
But they've had so many ball winners today. They're doing it very, very well. Like, considering what it was out late in the first quarter, this last quarter and a half has just been thorough domination.
Couldn't agree more, mate. Seaford need to be smart with their ball use, and they just need to get some scoreboard pressure. They need to keep it inside 50 while they can and hopefully turn that into a score. So,
yeah, take it. Yeah, long kick towards the forward pocket by Fisher. Ball off the pack, taken by, I think it was Bo Hendry, got the hand pass, and now another one. And Pines are away, sort of. No, good
pressure.
Oh, tried to charge through. Sure, he's taken on the tackle. Sure, he might be holding the ball, but not to be.
Bit unlucky there.
Umpire letting play go on. Ball in the left forward pocket, the Forest drive into the ground. Seaford into attack. Ball still there, not going too far. Packer players developed. Now the ball comes out once again. Luke Smith applies a sling tackle, and the umpire says, I'm going to ball it up.
Good pressure there from Seaford. They showed a bit of fight just to return that footy inside 50. The free kick. Such an important kick this, Rossi. Probably a bit of an understatement, but so important. Getting there, 8 goals down. You know, the coach has got the footy right in front of the locals there, but he really needs to put this through.
So an opportunity. For a shot at goal by Crow. Much needed. Has the shot. And puts it through for a goal, and much, much needed goal there for Seaford. Ben Crowe, his first goal for the afternoon. Seaford a 5-4-34, Pines 12-4-76. And that's on the Rye Hotel scoreboard. This game, of course, brought to you by the Mornington Rose by Telstra Stores. Thanks to Pete and the team, and the best on ground is sponsored by Pro Vendor, keeping agents honest.
Skill kick that one, much needed, and I did like the celebration from him. I just saw his teammates there to see that up and about, and kick the goal, get excited about it, and hopefully generate a bit of momentum. So, good kick, Benny Crow.
Ball back to the middle. Quick kick, mark taken by White. Short pass, taken by Trent Potts, a kick towards half forward. Mark taken by Messina, a hand pass to Luke Potts, goes in short towards his teammate there, who couldn't take the mark there, was Strawn. Ball to be picked up by Luke Smith in the back pocket. Now a long kick out towards set of wings here on Shawgale's 39. Ball comes to the back. It's taken for Pines by Taylor. Short pass, and the mark's been taken by Barry in the centre of the ground. Goes out towards his teammate, Lord Daniel, on centre wing. He plays on. He goes down the line towards the attacking side of centre wing there. It was kicked forward there by Tedge. He was looking for Edwards, who is besieged in the right on the boundary line there, about 50 out from the Pines goal, and the umpire says throw it back into play.
Just that contest out on the other side there, you know, Seaford were going forward, hasn't done it, you know, a lot of things haven't gone their way today, but Shaw just needed to do more, and the footy ended up going to his direct opponent who he left off the contest, so just another transition for Pines.
There's a quick kick forward towards centre wing, off the pack. Barry tried to get the ball out. Ball falls free, a chance for Luke Potts. He's been very, very good. There's a hand pass, and now another one for Pines, and now they go across the other side of the ground. Mark's been taken by a Mariner who goes towards half 40. He's looking there for Trent Potts, ducks under a tackle, gets the ball inside attacking 50. Pines player came out, he might have hurt himself in actual fact. Just keep an eye on that, Brent, as the ball goes towards the line and goes over for a boundary throw-in. 42 points the margin, but Pines player going hard at the contest just might have hurt himself.
Yeah, hopefully he's getting up on his feet. Might be a little bit winded, mate, but Goggy says he'll be all right.
Big fella, Taylor Strawn, I think. This ball comes back into play. It's picked up here for Seaford, and a hand pass, a poor one. It's a chance for Pines once again. And they go towards centre half forward. The mark has been taken. And it's been taken by Aaron Edwards.
I liked about that, Mark Vossie. He took it at its highest point. You know, he gave his defence. He gave his direct opponent just no chance to spoil that ball at all. It was up high, leaped early, took it at its highest point, one touch. Good mark.
So Edwards it is, going for goal number five from 45 metres directly in front. Has the shot. He's just hooked that one a little bit. That's a poor kick and through for a behind. I suppose they're caught in the horns of a dilemma a little bit, like with a guy like Edwards. So he's a quality player and he's played obviously AFL football and a fair bit of it. But when you consider that you can go to that player too often in a way, and that's probably not to go to him too often.
Yeah, definitely. I think he obviously demands the footy with his movements and his voice, but you're spot on, Vossie. They become too predictable, they'll be easier to defend. So I think what I've liked about their game today, Henry's bobbed up. You know, a few of the other bigger forwards have come up and taken some good marks. So they've got some versatility down there, which is good for them.
There's a short pass, and the mark has been taken by Kieran Shaw right in front of us. Kieran Shaw goes towards half forward. Mark not taken there by Fisher. Hand pass over the top. Ends up, I think, was that Chadwick that was tackled? It was Chadwick that was tackled. The umpire says, I'm going to ball it up. Knocked down on this occasion towards the forward pocket. Now Pines will clear. Short pass ends up with Luke Potts. He's called his name a lot and called Trent as well a lot.
Absolutely, Potts' balls have been going fantastic. They're getting a lot of free and being a good driving force for Pines.
So Sean White's got it. Long kick down towards half forward. Going up, taking a high mark, taking a good mark was Edwards. Aaron Edwards it is, goes towards half forward.
Good spoil.
Ball knocked away and over the line. Is it? No, stays in play. Mariner's got a hand pass to McLean Wilson over the top to Strawn. 25 metres out, Taylor Strawn has the shot and misses. So 12-6, 78, play 5-4-34. The margin is 44 points. That's on the Rye Hotel scoreboard. And just in case you're wondering, Melbourne were 9 points in front in the AFL halfway through the third quarter of that game.
Seaford keep wanting to play long ball footy out of their back half, and Pines have pressed all their numbers up into the centre of the ground. They need to be a bit smarter. If they're going to do that, they need their forwards up under their defenders, so to create a little bit of an even contest. But, you know, Pines are definitely outnumbering them at the moment, and every time they go long, it's just really hurting them. So they need to be a bit smarter with the footy.
Ball will be thrown back into play. Free kick. And free kick going to Seaford. and thought it was going to go to Kane Taylor. Actually, Kane Taylor was one that had a really good first quarter, but basically, in that second quarter, did virtually zippo.
Yeah, you see, it wasn't a run. I think a lot of the safety guys are there. That was a great mark by Sherwin. 3-on-1.
Long kick, mark taken by Chadwick, 50.
So they're right on the back end. This is the benefit if they come up to where their defenders are in the middle of the ground. They can beat them on the transition into the space, and they just got to get some guys with some good wheels, pushing back towards goal, and if they get an opportunity, kick it out in front of them.
So Chadwick from left half forward. Derek Chadwick has kicked 3 of their 5.
Needs a shape here.
Long kick. It's not going to be a goal. It's been knocked through for a point by Fisher, in actual fact. Pinespire was going to take the mark, but Fisher decided, well, I'll knock it through for a point. At least get a score on the board for us.
It's important forward, too. They're out of position. They're actually defenders, so it's important that they don't try and play for a mark when they're out of the position there.
Long kick down towards half back. Ball comes to the ground. Chance here. Might have been Braun, in actual fact. It was a hand pass, and now another one.
Good play.
Chance for Seaford. They can get the ball forward. They do on this occasion. The mark has been taken in the pocket, and it's been taken there by Ben Searle, who goes in short. He's got a teammate there on the lead in Rourke Fisher, and that's not going to be an easy kick at all. He's not kicking from basically the same sort of angle and same sort of distance.
Not an easy kick, but I did like the way they held their footy up. Pines really come back and compress the defensive 50, so it was good that he found another target, which was a bit closer to goal for him.
Long kick. Goal. That's a good kick. I said it wasn't going to be an easy kick. He made me look like a monkey's backside there. That's a goal, and a very good one at that, and one that Seaford really needed. 6 goals, 5:41, and Pines are 12-6-78. That's on the Rye Hotel scoreboard. You're listening. In fact, you're not listening because we can't go to a break at the moment because we don't. All right, anyhow, that's fine. Listeners don't need to wait and know that, but we'll hold here for the moment. That's a good goal by Fisher.
Yeah, definitely. Like I said, I was really happy with the way Seaford held the footy up there, waited for a little hit up, little opportunity to get a little bit closer to goal, and he put it through, which was great. And Seaford have actually just started this quarter pretty well, Rossi in a really positive frame of mind. So whatever Benny Crowe said during the half-time was certainly working.
Throw up by the umpire, and now chance for Seaford to clear, and they do. I think they might have been tied out of the middle out towards half-time.
That was a good kick.
Mark has been taken, and they can play on through Searle. Goes towards full forward, but that's a poor kick. You've still got that coach, Brent, in you, even though you're not coaching officially today in this game, but you're just getting a little bit frustrated with some of the possession there at times.
Look, he had his opponent burned. He went inside, and he just needed to find a target inside 50, so look, Seaford would be disappointed with that kick.
Aaron Edwards, good pressure. Ball comes out.
Go with Phil Edwards.
Still a chance at centre-half, 40 perhaps. That Seaford will win out with a quick kick out towards...
Williams having a good quarter. Rossi is getting his hands on the ball and using it really well.
Herbert goes down the line. Mark's taken by Kieran Shaw. He can play on. He goes towards Chadwick.
Good kick.
He charges out and takes the mark and gives his opponent a bit of a clip with it. All legally, mind you. Just gave him the hip and shoulder just to let him know that he was in a contest. Chadwick passed off and the mark has been taken. 35 metres out, straight behind this, it's Rourke Fisher. And this is a chance for Seaford to get back to within 31 points, which will be 3 goals to 1 in this quarter if in fact he is successful.
Williamson's just coming off there. He's been a really good...
That was an absolute mung of a kick, and that is
really good,
off target.
Really good play for Seaford this quarter. Again, that forward entry style with Williamson, so he's... get back on, Sam, we'll have a drink and get back into it. So he's playing some good footy.
Long kick out of defence for Pines, out towards the non-broadcast side, the scoreboard side. Mark not taken, ball falls to the back.
2-on-1 here, Seaford.
Seaford win out.
Well played.
Hand pass. Crow it was. Kieran Shaw's got it around the corner towards Walton. Aaron Walton, who's played Italy football himself before, goes in short. Mark not taken by Luke Smith. He picks it up though, Luke Smith. He has the shot and he puts it through for a goal. Margin back to 30 points here at Eric Bell Reserve. Pines are 12-6-78. Seaford 7-6-48. And that's Luke Smith's second goal. And two quality goals he's kicked this afternoon.
Yeah, great finish. Just injecting a bit of life into this game, Seaford. It's great that they've come out and responded. And obviously, you know, it might be a bit of a scoring end there. Maybe a slight breeze. I'm not too sure. It doesn't look it. But certainly they've come out in a great frame of mind this third quarter. And giving Pines something to think about, Rossi.
So, ball back to the middle. Margin is 30 points. So Seaford just starting to ask a couple of questions here. Can they get a little bit closer? Good tackle on Messina, and the umpire says, I'm going to ball it up once again.
Seaford has come up into this stoppage now, just for taping them up in there. It's good to see Crowley go to him.
Umpire Travis Denley says, I'm going to ball the ball up once again in the centre of the ground. Margin 30 points. Rye Hotel scoreboard 78-48 in favour of Pines. Ball knocked down. Tyreke's got it. High kick forward. There for Seaford towards centre half forward. Almost a mark to kill, and Shaw. He's pulled down his opponent there. That's a free kick. And the free kick is going to go to Bo Hendry. He goes out towards half back. Mark has been taken. I think that was taken by a Mariner, in fact, who went in short towards Taylor. He's got it, centre half back. He goes out towards the centre wing, and that's a poor kick. Just weighted too heavily there for Potts of the leap variety. Mark taken by Tyreke, went towards half forward. The mark has been taken by Walt Fisher. He's 55 or so metres out from goal. He's got not much of an angle to contend with. This is certainly going to test his distance.
They'd love to be within four or three-quarter time, Rossi.
Long kick. Good kick for distance, just off target. So 7-7-49 plays 12-6-78. Margin is 29 points. Rye Hotel scoreboard as the ball heads out towards half back. The mark is taken by Strawn. Plays on Trent Potts down the line towards half forward. Poor kick, mark taken for Seaford. They can play on Walton. A hand pass, and here's a chance for Seaford to go forward towards centre half forward, going up and not taking the mark. Oh, the umpire said, what's the
kick,
paid advantage. And now he's saying, no, you've got to go back and have your shot because it wasn't advantage. Umpire Rowan David, just start clarifying what's going on out there. So the ball is with Ben Searle.
Can he get the journey, Rossi?
Well, I reckon he's given him a little bit in this third quarter, in actual fact. He set up a goal before and just been lively with even three or four touches. Kick it, goal.
Precious on it.
That's a good kick. That's a goal. Margin back to 23 points here at Eric Bell Reserve. Pines 12-6-78. Seaford 8-7-55. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula Football.
The Tent Place is the biggest tent warehouse in Australia, with the biggest range of outdoor furniture. All their furniture is made from genuine plantation tent. Come and see for yourself. The Tent Place is only 40 minutes drive from Melbourne. Or see them online at thetentplace.com.au. With delivery to Melbourne daily and a 3-year warranty on all purchases. The Tent Place has your outdoor requirements completely covered. For more, phone The Tent Place 0413 937 389. Drop in and see them at 208 Barnyard Road, Rosebud, Victoria, a station sponsor.
98.7 The Locker Room covers all sports from all over the peninsula. Every Saturday morning from 10:30 till 12, find out what's happening locally from your sports station, RPPFM. 98.7 The Locker Room.
Welcome back here to Eric Bell Reserve, and all of a sudden we've got a ball game here. Michael Voss and Brent Clinic, and Brent Seaford just 4-1 in this quarter, looking a hell of a lot better.
Absolutely, mate. They're getting their hands on the floor, looking a little bit more desperate, but probably most importantly, Voss, they're defending well. When Pines have got the free, they're actually able to get the free back pretty quickly, and then actually doing what Pines are doing to them in a second, hurting them on transition. So it's important they keep it up, and I think we're in for a pretty good finish, mate.
Yeah, look, if they can just get another one, and all of a sudden an 8-goal lead's going to look going to look a long way away for you for Pines, because all of a sudden, Seaford are just asking a few questions. Can they kick a goal here? Strawn goes inside attacking 50, couldn't take the mark. Ball on the ground. Trent Potts is in there playing a tackle. The umpire says, I'm going to ball it up. So 23 points the margin in favour of Pines. Rye Hotel scoreboard 78 to 55. We'll try and get you an update on what's happening in the Tyabs Somerville game shortly. There's a quick snap, but I have no idea who kicked that one, but it's through for a point.
You might have been Hendry down there, mate.
So 8-8-56. Plays 12-6. In fact, it's 12-7-79 to 8-7-55. So the margin is 24 points. As Luke Smith comes in from fullback, that's an absolute shocker. And you'll never guess who's here, listeners. Mr. Whippy is here.
He's going to put that straight in the van there.
I'll tell you what, Mr. Whippy might have even called that one. And that is, every game seemingly, Mr. Whippy arrives. There's a short pass by Edwards towards the pocket. Not a good kick. The mark has been taken there. And now a short pass out towards the right back pocket. Chance for Seaford now because they've got a 50-metre penalty. Scoreboard side of the ground. All of a sudden, just the small things going their way and it's working their way back.
It's amazing how that happens, Vossi. Absolutely. Your 50-50 decisions start going your way. The bounce of the ball. You know, just the little things that help with a bit of momentum. So, 2-on-1 here. We've retained the footy again.
Just wonder how much of an effort it's going to be. That's holding the ball. That is just lack of football awareness of what was going on around him there, because that should have been, well and truly, he should have known what was going on, at least someone should have told him, but how much of an effort is it going to be to get them back into the game though, but that's the big thing.
Yeah, I looked after, obviously spent a fair few petrol tickets to get themselves back in the game, in a position they actually threatened the result, so, look, they still need to do a lot more work, they need a couple more goals, and, you know, I said they'd be wrapped to be within four goals at three-quarter time. I think they might be able to adjust that and say three if they can keep this intensity up.
So, load up once again from right full back here, Seaford. They're 8-7-55 and Pines are 12-7-79. Rye Hotel scoreboard, short pass. Mark not taken there by Campbell. Ball on the ground, a chance for McLean Wilson. A hand pass now, quick kick for Pines towards the far side. It's actually gone through for a behind.
Seaford may be breathing a bit of a sigh of relief there. They'll put that foot inside to a 50-50 short. It's just asking for trouble, but got out of it, got the footy back with a kick in.
So, margin 25 points. Short pass. Mark's been taken. They can play on. They switch play once again. Out to Kieran Shaw, I think that was tackled. The umpire's right back into play. This game, of course, brought to you by the Telstra Stores, Mornington and Rosebud. Thanks to Pete and the team. Good day here, and I don't know how you've got a jacket on there, Rips. It is absolutely sweltering. It's been sweltering in there. It's a warm one here this afternoon at Pines, and we're in early April. Here's a short pass. Now an opportunity for Pines to line up, go towards full forward, and Hendry goes back, couldn't take the mark. Can he recover that ball off the hands of the pack and three for behind?
See, if they've got to move this quick here. They allow Pines to get their press going. There's just no room for him up through the centre of the ground. So look for a quick handball here or a play on, which he has.
12-9-81 plays 8-7-55. Margin is 26 points. Here's an opportunity now, long kick.
It's a 1-on-4,
and that one did extremely well.
Oh, in mate,
Fisher.
Oh, well.
He's asking for help. He can't do it all on his own balls. Get in there and help him. Searle gets in there, and the umpire says, I'm going to ball it up, but he did really well there, Will Fisher, just to hold that ball up.
Brilliant play. Didn't result in direct possession for him, but absolutely fantastic. I mean, Benny Crowe seeing that would be absolutely thrilled with that pressure he applied there. 4-on-1. Retain the footy. It's back to a 50-50 at least. Getting up a little bit worse for wear, but hold your head high, mate. You did well, Will.
Can they sneak one here before three-quarter time? Here's an opportunity. Ty Ricky goes in short. That's a poor kick. And the mark has been taken by the man who's been doing it on the forward line, but now he went back and took a mark in defence just to sense the danger. That was Aaron Edwards. Now a chance for Pines to clear far side of the ground. Kick in short. Not a good one. Still an opportunity here for Seaford, perhaps, if they can lock the ball up. Good tackle. Kieran Shaw, a hand pass. Here's an opportunity. Got Walton on his own in the square and goes to him. In fact, just outside the square in actual fact. But Aaron Walton will go back and should put through the ninth goal on the board. which will make the margin 20 points, and that was good because Aaron Martin got three of his man, and he couldn't blast away from 25 out on an angle, but instead did the disciplined thing.
Yeah, definitely. He's tested the umpire there, but Matt done the right thing there, and just edging his way back in, safe, aren't they? So I hope Corey brings up about that contest there by Rock Fisher and what it did for his team. They're really pressing Seaford, didn't give up the footy, and just a great team act.
Pines 12-9-81, Seaford 9-7-61. Pro Vendor, the best on grounds by keeping agents honest. And this game all of a sudden has got a bit of life back in it. 20 points is the margin. Now just the Pines bench just sort of looking around and just sort of looking at the board and just a worried look or two on their faces there. Just that this quarter hasn't gone the way they planned it, especially I think they hit the first goal of the quarter, I think, as well, which made it even a little bit worse for them, I suppose. Here's an opportunity. Crow got the hand pass out. He was looking there for a teammate, but the ball bounced off his chest. And in the centre of the ground, the umpire says it's a two-way decision.
Great pressure from Pines there. See if he's doing the right thing, though. They're trying to move it quick now that they've got the momentum. So
quick kick by Luke Potts towards full forward, leading out. Hendry, hand pass out of the top, Messina, he's kicked two goals, Jamie Messina, he's not going to kick a goal there, the Seaford players, is about three of them apply a gang tackle and the umpire says ball it up, Pines by 20 points, Seaford just got to hold out here, Brent.
Absolutely, they'd, it wouldn't be a bad option to put some numbers behind the ball just to close the quarter out, you wouldn't want Pines getting an easy one or two to close the quarter when you've done such good work and you want to be right in at three quarter time, so. Just try and retain possession, score if you can, get to a point on the middle of the ground and pull the trigger and try and go forward, but
the ball just about went in the front seat of Mr. Whippy's van there. It was out of bounds from the fall.
Ball mangled out there, Vossie.
Attracts of plenty of attention, that's for sure. 20 points is the margin. Here at Pines, we'll try and update you on the tie, and tie, but some of will score shortly as well, and see if we can find out something from Sereno and Tramana. You'd think Sereno would probably, well, certainly go in as warm favourites in that one, but you just never know, round one. Strange things can happen. Short pass. Out towards half-back. Ball knocked away and over the line for a boundary throw-in.
Certainly a little bit of feeling out there, Vossie, isn't there? There's just a little bit of spice in the game at the moment, and Pines certainly wouldn't be enjoying Seaford's revival here.
They certainly would not. Umpire once again calls for a ball up. Let's have a look at the situation. Sorrento 8-3-51, Jermana 5-4-34, Somerville 11-13-79, Tyab 10-12-72.
Wow, so it's some tight games of footy.
If I can get a win with Stephen Norman this side, I reckon I'll just about make him mayor of Tyab if there is such a title.
Give him the keys.
Give him the keys to the city, absolutely. Here's a chance to Pines, a hand pass. Daniel gets the hand pass out of the top. He needs someone there, but he hasn't got one. Here's an opportunity there for Seaford to go with Walton. Out towards halfback goes with a long kick. Kieran Shaw, he needed to take that man as it was. But it didn't really matter because the siren's on. He was 150 metres out from goal anyhow. So Pines at three-quarter time. 12-9-81, Seaford 9-7-61. Hopefully we've got a good last quarter for you. We'll tell you all about it after the break. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula Football. Okay, so what did the coaches have to say?
Just really had a moment to listen to Peter Swain there. Probably didn't get rewarded for effort. I think they kicked one goal four, one goal five, so he was critical of their entries while they were playing the footy. They want to get some more shots from, the goal mouth and in that V coming out of the goal square. So a little bit better execution and a little bit critical of the backs not running on transition. So should be a good finish, mate. They're pretty happy about points.
Start of the last quarter, first goal crucial. Seaford get it, we got a real game here, Brent.
Absolutely, mate.
Start of the last quarter, Quanchy and Strawn in the ruck. Ball comes to the ground, a chance here for Quanchy, a hand pass. Searle's given them plenty since he came to the ground, probably in the third quarter. Off the ground, mark taken though by Bo Hendry, who goes towards centre half back, and the mark has been taken. And a quick kick there for Pines towards half forward.
Well,
Trent Potts get back into the contest. No, he can't.
And just coming onto the ground there was Taylor, but he managed to not be able to pick up the ball. The ball will be thrown back into play. Boundary umpire ready to throw the ball back into play. Knockout towards the boundary line. It's picked up by Crow. That's a terrible kick by Ben Crow, and only got himself to blame for that one. Had a real opportunity there. He probably could have maybe just drilled that one in more towards attacking 50 and maybe given them an opportunity, but that was really just a terrible execution.
Yeah, for sure. I'd be disappointed with that, but going back to that stoppage, I mean, they almost lined out the two teams there. You know, Seaford on one side, Pines on the other. So that tap from the Seaford rapper, probably fortunate enough to find Benny Crow there. Was certainly outnumbered, but just poor execution from Crow.
Here's an opportunity for Pines. They can kick one. They just might kill off a bit of resistance here if they can sneak one. In the early stages, there's Luke Potts. Goes in short. Toe poke, not a good kick. He was looking for Edwards, but the ball goes over the line and out of play for a boundary throw in. Left forward pocket. Forrest drive into the ground.
Big pace, Wayne. He pretty supportive of that kick because he brought that up to the group at three-quarter time. And the entries and where they're leading to, so all they're leading to into the pocket, and he wants to be a little bit more direct and have easy shots at goal when they do take a mark.
25 metres out from the Pines goal. Forrest drive into the ground. The umpire says, I'm going to ball it up once again as a result of that boundary throw-in. 20 points still the margin. Pines hanging on.
First goal crucial, Rossi, as you pointed out.
If they can, they would snuff out a fair bit of resistance if they can kick one. That's out of bounds to four. So, and Melbourne are 8 points in front of the AFL, Brent. So Melbourne hanging on there. That's halfway through the last quarter in that one. So long kick out towards half forward, or half back, I should say, off the pack. A quick kick. Big jump at the side by Tedge. Couldn't take the mark. The umpire says, I'm going to ball it up. Right smack bang in the goal square. Dale Tedge glided like a bird there, but just couldn't bring the ball down.
Just going back from that, just a poor spoil by Shaw. Really, the ball come up. He had to do more with it. He just spoiled it straight back into the corner. He straight to Pines on the turnover. So just needed to get closer to the boundary line. A bit of a defensive spoil would have been good.
Ball knocked through for a rush behind. So Pines are up now to 12-10-82. Seaford at 9-7-61, Rye Hotel scoreboard. They need more from Kane Taylor in this last quarter. Give him a lot of rebound. Here's an opportunity for them. A chain of hand passes, ends up on centre wing. Kick off the ground. Keep going. Keep that ball going forward your way. Here's an opportunity if Luke Smith can pick up the ball. Not quite on this occasion. And the umpire, Travis Stanley, says, I'm going to ball the ball up.
Need a little bit of help from his teammates when he's paddling that ball in front of himself. Would have been nice for a block just to free up, get a bit of separation.
Umpire Denley says, I'm going to ball the ball up once again. Played about 5 minutes in the last quarter, and no change except a point to Pines.
There's a lot of ink kicking around, isn't there, Rossi? Boys with the tats.
Dare I say it, we're in the Pines.
Well, we get everywhere these days, Rossi.
You're right.
You've got your total appointment booked in this week, I've heard.
It doesn't have to be in the Pines, but yeah, there's plenty of it around, that's for sure.
Good smarter, sorry.
Here's an opportunity now for Messina. He was tackled. He rode the tackle, and now he got the free kick. Now he goes towards half court. Now, and Edwards has got it. 50 metres out from goal. He goes high, he goes long, he goes straight. Every dollar we're paying him is absolutely worth it. That's a good goal by a player that they expect him to do that, but boy, oh boy, that was a much needed goal for Pines. Gives him a bit of breathing space. 13-10-88 plays 9-7-61. Margin is 27 points. That is on the Rye Hotel scoreboard. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula Football.
Hi, I'm Jack, and I love Pete from the Mornington and Rosemont Toaster Stores. This year's winners of the Toaster Licence Standing Award. My dad has been really busy lately, but he in turn has been recognised for their customer service excellence. And you really need to get in store and experience it for yourself. So drop in and see the Toaster Licence of the Year team at the Toaster Store in Mornington or Rosemont.
Of course, I want to see you on Toaster.
And in the meantime, I'm off to go kick the floor with Dad. Well done, Dad.
Thanks, Sam.
A station sponsor.
I think he's been terrific.
Tick inside attacking 50, needing a mark down there and will get paid. And I think it's Paddy Cat who's going to get the ball and have the shot at goal. And this to answer, it's a much needed goal here for Seaford if they can get it. Margin is 27 points.
Need to put this in and go back to back, don't they, Rossi? So, super important as Kane Taylor re-enters the play.
Melbourne are going to win in the AFL, by the way. For what it's worth, they're 30 points in front, 22 minutes in the last quarter.
Yeah, I know a few people that ventured into the MCG, so I'd be pretty happy going home today.
The old trumpeter will be trumpeting out the... That's a grand old flag. Here's a shot at goal. And that's a point.
Well, we need to pick that, Pat. Paddy hasn't had a lot of footy today, so it's important as a small forward. You need to take your chances. He'd be disappointed with that.
Yeah, they're just not making the most of their opportunity there. That was a shorter distance kick than what Edwards had before. And Edwards kicked the goal and Cad, the star for Seaford, didn't. And speaking of Edwards, here's another chance. He'll kick from close to 50 once again.
That's coast to coast from Pines Footy Club there. Just great play. As soon as the ball went through for the points, they went to move it quickly. Caught Seaford napping slightly defensively and just exposed some holes and got the footy half forward really quickly. And then, so once you do that, you move it quick between the arcs, you're going to isolate your forward. So there was plenty of room for him to lead into, and Edwards got another shot.
Edwards has a shot and misses.
He's kept a couple of points today too, was he?
Yeah, five goals two. There's a kick out towards Crowe, takes the mark, back pocket. So Ben Crowe with the ball. Spoke to him on the footy show this morning. Quick out towards centre wing. And ball off the hands of the pack and goes over the line for a boundary throw-in. Pines by 27 points. Thanks to Pete and the team. We're live here at the Eric Ball Reserve, the Mornington Race by Telstra Stores. Ball thrown back into play. And Messina tackled. Over the line goes the ball. The pro vendor, best on ground, keeping agents honest. It's almost time to start thinking about that. Boy, oh boy, it's going to be a tough one.
Oh, it certainly is. Obviously, at half-time, that any number of Pines guys could have ownership in the best on ground, but certainly Seaford have really, you know, turned the screws on the game, and we're going to have a good finish, mate.
Umpire says ball it up.
You know, from Pines, obviously, the Potts boys have been fantastic. Edwards up front. A couple of other big fellas having an impact. For Seaford, I love Williamson's game. I thought he's been terrific. Who else is there? How do you say that one?
Tyre Ricky.
He's certainly been influential as well. So, getting along the ball.
There's a kick down towards centre wing. And then a goal there, Seaford. Nothing's really happening for them in this last quarter. They just need something to happen just to give them a chance. But that's a poor kick around the corner. Should enable Pines to clear if they are good enough, but they lose control of the ball. Still loose here on half forward. Umpire Gent says, I'm going to ball the ball up. Yeah, I've got to say I'm probably leaning towards one of the Potts or Edwards myself at the moment.
Yep,
but,
fair call, mate.
It's obviously been a pretty good effort when you consider what Pines have put up this afternoon. Aside from that third quarter, you did say they kicked a few points in that, but it's been a pretty good performance overall, and they deserve their lead and probably their victory, because they should go on and win from here. Here's an opportunity, O'Neill for Seaford. Well done there by Daniel. Ball towards the line. And goes over the line. Just kept that ball inside the scoring area.
Yeah, great pressure from Pines there.
Ball will be thrown back into play. Taken by Smith. Hand pass to Tyreke. Hand pass to Williamson. Was tackled. Good pressure there by the Pines team. Ball at centre half 40 and the umpire's going to call for a ball up. Umpire Brett Gent. Pines leading 13-11-89. Plays 9-8-62. Margin is 27 points on the Rye Hotel scoreboard. right by umpire Gent. Knocked down.
Sunderland were up by 7 points at three-quarter time, Posse. Obviously, that might be 15 minutes late, but certainly a tight contest down the pond, mate.
I wonder how much Stephen Milne will have to say at three-quarter time. I wonder whether they'll use the fact that obviously it's his only game for the side, and just I wonder how much they'll use him in terms of trying to get the boys up and fired for the last quarter.
Yeah,
would you do it if you were the coach?
Look, it's you got to really assess the game on its merits here, Rossi. You try and isolate the gun forward any time you call in the last quarter and try and get as much footy into him as you can. So,
Seaford haven't scored in this last quarter and haven't really looked like it, to be honest. They look a little bit tight, actually, the Seaford boys. Crow in there trying to get the ball out. He does, towards Luke Smith. Picked up by Luke Smith, a hand pass towards... That was a quick kick by Quanchy, in fact, towards centre-half for a ball off the pack. And the Pines defence just all of a sudden they just stopped. They were tackled very well. Seaford boys look very tired.
Yeah, it can sometimes happen, boss. You had a really good third quarter and fought really hard to get yourself back into a game.
Not out of them.
Absolutely, mate. It can happen. It's just really, it's a more of a mental thing. You come in a three-quarter time and you can't be just content with getting yourself back into the game. You've got to go on the level and actually try and wrestle the ball back.
There's a shot and there's a goal.
But certainly their body language, Rossi, I mean, if they can get another one now, the lactic acid might have gone away and they're up and about and they can get a few more entries. And
I think the goal was kicked through by Nicholas Braund, I think that was, who kicked that one. So that's his first goal for the afternoon. And while there's life, there's hope, I suppose.
Yeah, absolutely. I want the Seaford fans and supporters here at Eric Bay Reserve will run another entry and a little bit of space and a bit more scoreboard pressure.
Kick off the ground by Walton. Well, he tried to, but didn't go any distance. Braund knocking the ball back or trying to. Still a chance here on centre wing. The ball is loose. Now kick off the ground goes Pines' way. Over the top comes the ball towards Gaganovic. Inside attacking 50. Having the shot and going across the face of goal and out of bounds on the full. And that missed by an absolute mile.
Yeah, that no wind took that one, Rossi. Just all directed, mate.
There's just no wind at all here today. Just a beautiful day for football.
Certainly is.
Trying to hold the ball in. Just thinking back 12 months ago, we broadcast Devon Meadows and Pearstyle the first game. That Devon Meadows ground, and that was looking magnificent as well as this ground is today, mind you, as well.
Yeah, absolutely. We're blessed in the Moyne Spinitcher footy league with some really good surfaces to play on. So, credit to the footy clubs and the councils.
The councils do a pretty good job with it, it's got to be said. Umpire David throwing the ball up. Margin is 21 points in favour of Seaford. Can they just perhaps get a goal here? But not to. What's happened here? Umpire's given a free kick.
Potts just went past the footy then and really got into Shaw physically. So.
And Williamson was behind the ref, recognised what they needed. I was trying to get the ball to Williamson, and he got a tackle and absolutely thrown into the ground and holding the ball and free kick to Guy Hendry. He goes long towards full forward, great off ball. The back. Ball on the ground in the left forward pocket. The umpire letting play go on, and the ball still going to be kept in play. It's going to be a ball up.
That's one thing with high forward entries with a congested situation. It really encourages that third man up for the sprawl. So, you know, Pines with their firepower, they could probably wait a little bit and generate another option through some maybe swinging the footy around and try to open up a little bit of space.
So McLean Wilson, by the look of it, is going to...
Bit of a Stevie J from the burning line.
Have the shot. He has the shot, he just misses. He just misses on that occasion.
Peter Munzo, didn't he, Wes? He looked pretty close.
Well, got the crowd involved.
Certainly did.
So, 13-12-90, plays 10-8-68. Margin is 22 points. And Pines looking as though they're going to go on and have a good win to start their season. Seaford have got Bomb Beach next week, I know that. Pines have got Lang Warren at Lang Warren next week. Long kick. Out towards half-back, ball off the pack. And here's a chance for Messina, a hand pass. That was Mailing, I think I got the hand pass now. Another one ends up with Edwards around the corner. Goes Aaron Edwards, and he has put through his sixth goal. And tell you what, he's just about, you're just going to be able to write him three votes in the book there, Brett, are you?
Yeah, just about, mate. It's, he's certainly getting some good help from his smaller midfielders too, getting a lot of good supply. And, but that was just more of an opportunist goal. He worked it really well, got a bit of space, and kicked through over his shoulder, so good goal, Aaron Edwards.
And that's the thing with a good forward. You need a good midfield. You need a midfield supply to get it down to him as well. But that's no reflection on the midfield. You just need to get the ball down to him. But he's the one that's finishing off all the great work that they're doing. And he's played an amazing game this afternoon.
Yep, certainly has. The midfield's been fantastic. We'll do well in the third quarter, but they're certainly responding now in the last.
There's Luke Smith. Long kick at goal by Luke Smith towards full forward, but it doesn't bounce through. In fact, it bounces calmly there for Pines, and they can clear the ball out the broadcast side. Kick down the line towards Gaganovic, who's got it. He goes around and he goes in short. He's looking for Taylor Strong. He's actually had a pretty good game himself, the big fella.
Yeah, he's taken some nice space, isn't he?
There's an injury to Pines, and it's actually Dale Tedge as well, which
looks a bit poppy, doesn't he?
Yeah, just a little bit poppy on the ankle there, right in front of us. Still an opportunity. Edwards, short pass, and it's Mark taken. I think it's by Luke Potts who's got it. It is Luke Potts. Yeah, no, Edwards has set up so many today. He's just been very, very unselfish.
Yeah, he's done well. Done a lot of team things. Only the third quarter when Seaford really pressing, he put himself behind the ball. We'll see. Good instruction from Paddy Swain. Draws the footy. Gives his defenders who are under the pump a little bit of a little bit of confidence. But as we say, well, he's just got himself another position, has he?
Luke Potts has just given it back to his good mate there, and Aaron Edwards will go back for goal number seven. And I reckon I reckon three votes A Edwards for me this afternoon.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, I'm probably 99% leaning with you, Lord, mate. It's he's been fantastic today in his first game for the Pines Footy Club.
And he's only going to get better. In terms of like getting used to the league and fitness and all that sort of stuff.
Yep.
Shot a goal, it's a poor kick. Threw from behind. +14, +13, +97 plays 10-8, 68. Pines are home. It's just a question of what the margin is. And little Buddy Glenn can actually have a little bit of a rest there on the sidelines. He's copped an absolute battering today, the runner there for Pines. Paddy Swain's making him work very, very hard.
Keep sending him out, Rossi. Keep sending him out.
don't want to let him get, don't want to relax too easy there, Brent.
No, mate. We're all around the messages. As my good mate Steve Walter did last year, just work him over.
There's a chance now for Seaford to go down the line through Luke Smith. Long kick towards centre wing. That's a good mark. They can play out here, and they do. Hand pass to Kieran Shaw. A hand pass. They're attacking side of centre here. A quick kick by Tad towards Searle. Couldn't get it. Ball on the ground. And the umpire says, I'm going to ball it up at centre half forward. So have you, sort of, as a coach, I'm sure you've probably wrote plenty of messages where you've sent something out and then something's come back at you, Brent?
Yeah, at times it does. You try not to...
It's part and parcel of being a coach, isn't it?
Well, the players get a little bit excited, a little bit... really involved in the game. It's an emotional game for you sometimes, and nothing too severe, Vossi.
There's a kick down the line, and it's kept in play. Quick kick forward there for Seaford towards half forward. Mark's been taken. It's been taken by Big Miller. Plays on, goes in short. Mark taken by Williamson. Probably Seaford's, certainly one of Seaford's better players.
Yeah, well, this game today, mate.
Kicking towards the left forward pocket, off the hands of the pack, a hand pass. Can Derek Chadwick put through his fourth goal? Trying to do a little bit too much, and the ball came off the end of his toe and through for behind.
They've certainly closed him up, haven't they, since quarter time?
We kicked three in the opening quarter and he's done nothing since. Long kick out towards half back on the ground. Crow, not where Ben Crow probably should be, although he is pretty good below his knees. In actual fact.
Yeah, I think he played a lot of midfield, as a big top midfielder when he's spent his time in the VFL, mate. So Yeah, obviously he'd rather start the season in a better fashion than this, but you know, there's some good signs for Seaford today. Hasn't been all doom and gloom.
So here's an opportunity for Seaford to get a late goal through the agency of Pat Tad. Tough kick, and even more so by the fact he's kicked it straight across the face of goal. Ball out 15 metres out from the Seaford goal, the score into the ground. Pines just trying to work their way out of trouble here. Pines would love to get another goal just to get that crack that 100-point barrier after all they were, 70 points at half-time.
Yep.
Just a little psychological thing. Throw up by the umpire, knocked down. I think by Bo Hendry it was. Quick kick. It's off target there for Seaford, three for a behind. So they're up to 10-10-70. Pines are 14-13-97. And we're late in the last quarter here. Shouldn't be too long to go at all. And we're live here at the Eric Bell Reserve, thanks to Pete and the team, the Mornington Race by Telstra Stores and Pro Vendor, sponsoring the best on-ground keeping agents honest. Aaron Edwards probably going to be the man this afternoon. He'll take out the trophy. Long kick towards half forward, off the pad. Comes the ball, a quick kick. A high kick, in fact. There by Doyle it was. It's taken for Pines. Gaganovic smothered. Cowell's got it. Cowell actually started right. It hasn't really done a lot in the second half, but started pretty well. Massena's been pretty solid most of the day as well.
Yeah, definitely. He's been around a long time. Massena, isn't he? So, proven player at the level, and yeah, he's just really contributed well for Pines today.
Of course, for what it's worth, the two sides, one playing at Macedon this year and one playing at Albury, the Italy teams this year.
Yep.
So both of them travelling this year. Here's an opportunity now for a quick kick down towards Trent Potts, who has had a good game, probably started off a little bit in the second half, but he's had a really good game though.
Yeah, I'd be happy with it. There's not a lot of Pines guys that you certainly wouldn't be putting across next to in terms of their performance at Albus. I think they've been pretty solid across the board and obviously a couple of outstanding contributions.
So Brown will be thrown back into play right in front of where Paddy Swain is standing. And he'll be a very happy man. He'll have a beer in his hand probably in about maybe half an hour, 40 minutes time, and he'll be very content knowing that they've had a good win to start the season.
Absolutely, it's the night before the end of round one, Vossi. It's a nervous time for coaches. You're making sure all your plans are put in place, and all you need are the boys to come to play. That's all you need from them, and certainly the Pines guys have done that today.
Well done by De Blasio there. A long kick towards centre half forward, off the pack goes the ball. The chance here for Pines to clear, a hand pass out towards the boundary line. It's not going to get anywhere near that. Here's a chance now for Rock Fisher on the left foot. Goes towards full forward off the hands. Comes to the back. Quick snap. It's by Herbert, I think. And he's put it through for a goal.
Pines have been disappointed with that. They got the ball to half back. To half forward safe. And Pines had the plus one. Just didn't make the most of the opportunity. Just spilled the full out. Safe had turned the ball back over and got it deep inside and got a shot on goal, was he?
So that is marching back to 21 points. I'm just looking there. It was Herbert who kicked the goal. So he was a goal kicker there for Seaford. I think that's his first goal for the afternoon. In actual fact, it is his first goal. He kicked the point in the first quarter. So margin 21 points. And Pines bring the ball forward towards half forward. Going up with one hand but not taking the mark. Guy Hendry gets the ball back. He's gonna be so much better player this year with Aaron Edwards playing. I'll tell you what, Guy Hendry.
Yeah, definitely looks a handful. Just selling a bit of candy there, big fella. Just showing a few party tricks late in the game, so.
Yeah, you think of him in the side now being not the number one target. And he's a quality player in his own right. There's Tench, he's back on the ground. He hurt his ankle earlier in the last quarter, but he's back on it. He's just put through a goal, and that puts the icing on a nice cake for Pines this afternoon. But, Guy Hendry, he's going to be so the beneficiary of having Aaron Edwards playing.
Absolutely. You know, Hendry might be able to play a bit of a secondary role to Edwards, and obviously the opposition are always going to put a lot more time into Edwards, and Henry definitely is going to see the benefits of that, and quite nimble for a big fella. Certainly own the air going forward, aren't they? Bossy, the big fellas have really stood up, got the free at the highest point, and
like you just said before, putting the icing on the cake now.
15-14, 104, plays 11-10-76. Here's the chance, can they get one more? Taylor Strawn with the ball, goes towards half forward, the mark has been taken. And a chance perhaps for Ed Woods, takes the mark. So Aaron Edwards, right forward pocket, about 35 metres out. I'll back him in here, Brent.
Yeah, well, he's had a good day.
He has the shot, or he just misses.
He's dead.
Crown went up too.
They did. What's up, Vossi? That's
6-4, I think he's got.
6-4?
I think 6-3, 6-4.
So, I mean, if he's had 9 shots himself, he's laid at least 2 or 3 off. So, you've got a key forward having, you know, 10, 11, 12 score involvements for the day. Geez, it's a good day. Good day at the office, mate.
There's a sign. A win this afternoon to Pines by 29 points, and they'll sing the song in the room very shortly, knowing that they've had a good start to their 2015 season. Pines 15-15-105, a beaten Seaford 11-10-76. We'll take a break, come back and wrap things up here from the Eric Bell Reserve on R Double P, the voice of Peninsula Football.